I want to show you three mistakes you really want to avoid when using optionals in Swift. Take a look at this code. I create an optional string that will hold either the string hello world or nil. And then I call the method reversed on that optional string. But notice how I call that method using two very different syntaxes. In the first case, I use a question mark, but in the second case, I use an exclamation mark. When you're new to Swift, this difference might seem like a detail, but it's actually really important. The first syntax, that's called optional chaining, will return an optional, meaning that when optional string actually holds a string, that optional will contain the reversed string, and when optional string is nil, that optional will also be nil. This optional chaining syntax is very useful because it allows us to interact with optionals in a very safe way. Its only downside is that we need to deal with an optional return value. On the other hand, the second syntax, that's called force unwrapping, will not return an optional. But this apparent simplicity comes at a price. Should optional string be nil, then this second syntax will lead to a crash. So most of the time, you probably want to use the first syntax called optional chaining because it offers a much safer way to interact with an optional. Another big pitfall of optionals is to not unwrap them in a way that is error-proof. Take a look at this code. First, I test that the optional isn't nil. And then, inside the if statement, I force unwrap the optional. At first glance, this might seem like a reasonable approach, but the issue lies in the fact that the force unwrap is happening independently of the condition. So if we later change the condition to something completely different, the force unwrap will still successfully build. However, there is now a chance that this force unwrap will lead to a crash. Fortunately, Swift comes with a built-in feature that is specifically made to solve this issue. By using optional binding, we are able to write a condition that will test whether the optional is nil, and that will also create a new non-optional value that we can safely access inside the if statement. Even better, since Swift 5.7, that optional binding syntax has become even shorter. Finally, the last mistake you want to avoid is to use an optional when it is actually not needed. Here I've defined a struct that represents a person, and I chose to represent the name of that person as an optional. However, notice that in the initializer of the struct, the name is not optional. This means that it's actually impossible to create a person whose name is nil. So it actually makes no sense to store the name as an optional because it doesn't solve any problem and only brings additional complexity. Of course, here my example might feel a bit far-fetched, but I assure you that when you work in a real app, it's actually easier than you think to end up with a situation where a value has been declared as optional for absolutely no good reason. So as a rule of thumb, I would suggest that you should start by making a value non-optional by default and only turn it into an optional when it's actually required. That's it. These were the three mistakes you definitely want to avoid when using optionals in Swift. I hope you've enjoyed this video and that it will help you improve the quality of your code. Remember to subscribe to the channel. It's really a big support for me. Thank you for watching and see you next time.